speaking not just about cars, but about trucks as well, and multi-axle truck sales in the US has kept companies like Bharat Forge up and about through 2017. And with brokerages expecting a similar run this year, the going's only going to get more exciting. To talk about the company, joining us now is the Chairman and Managing Director, Baba Kalyani, and Yatin is here to take forward that discussion. Yatin.
Thanks for that, Neeraj. Talking about Bharat Forge, Mr. Kalyani, thank you so much for joining in and happy 2018. If you talk about the domestic business first, and that is something which has been quite strong for most of the auto ancillaries in India. So talking about the outlook moving forward for the domestic business, how really do you see business shaping up in the domestic market?
Well, the domestic demand right now for all the products that we conventionally were supplying, largely to the CV market and to some extent to the passenger business, is pretty strong. It's a matter of fact, like, extremely strong. We are pretty good on the domestic side. We are also increasing our penetration in many other products that go into automotive industry, mainly in the transmission related products. So we will see our content per vehicle going up. You will see it in 2018, 2019. So we see the domestic market reasonably strong.
As Neeraj was mentioning, the overseas business and the trucking business there, if you could tell us how really is the export market business shaping up, especially US and Europe, since we have the forecast for Class 8 trucks for 2018 quite strong. So on that projection, and given the fact that the US growth is picking up, how do you see the business shaping up there?
See, as far as the CV business in the US is concerned, 2017 was somewhere in the region of 275,000. I think the numbers will come out in December as to what it ended up. 2018 is likely to be 320,000. And 2019 is likely to be again above 300,000. So you're going to have some 3-4 strong years as far as the CV business in North America is concerned. Number two, we have gained market share in the CV North American business, so we are seeing much more business than we would have normally seen. And again, as what we are doing in India, we're doing the same thing there. How do we, you know, supply more products into a truck? So we are looking at other parts of the vehicle, transmission-related products. A lot of changes are coming in with emission control, the Euro 6 version or equivalent. There's a lot of change in the way transmissions will be produced in the future. So this is a big opportunity for people like us to increase our share of business. So we are very bullish about this as far as CV is concerned in North America. As far as automotive is concerned, which is largely passenger and SUVs, we continue to grow in that market. We continue to get more and more contracts, and that's a growth area for us. So there also we will see a fairly strong growth coming in, both from North America as well as Europe, as far as our business is concerned.
Okay, but sir, talking about the domestic market, and my earlier question, you were mentioning the fact that the growth is quite good. And I assume that, your capacity utilization would be, over 80%. So in that scenario, do you think in the domestic market, there is a need to look at a very large amount of capital expenditure or capacity expansion plan? And also, if no capex is there, are you looking at some acquisitions in the domestic market which will augment your capacity as well as your, product portfolio?
Well, first of all, let me address the issue of capex. Yeah, we are now almost running out of capacity, so we are going to increase our capital expenditures in 2018 and 2019 to build new capacities. Some of the new things that we are doing is lightweight components. So we are building a plant in Andhra Pradesh for lightweight, it's going to be a center of lightweight technology. So it's going to be aluminum, magnesium, and many different types of technologies, casting, hydroforming, and others. So you will see those products coming up by 2019 into the marketplace. And we are expanding our capacities in Baramati. That's the only place we have in Maharashtra, close by to our plant, where we have infrastructure and land available. So we are going to add a lot of capacities there. So you will see a fair amount of capex in 2018 and 19 as far as capacities are concerned. As far as looking at distress assets, yeah, we are looking at distress assets. We are in the market. And we will see. I mean, each opportunity has to be evaluated on its own merits. And we are in touch with the bankers. We are fairly closely following the whole NCLT process that's currently going on as per the bankruptcy laws. And maybe we might find something that's useful for us in terms of growth.
That's sir, but talking about the non-automotive segment of your business, especially the oil and gas segment, you know, I understand you provide a lot of forgings and you know, products to the oil and gas industry. And since we have the oil prices which have firmed up, overall commodity prices are moving higher, especially the fag end of 2017, and expected to remain strong in the first half at least of 2018. So on that front, you know, talking about the non-automotive business segment, how do you see growth shaping up there?
Well, that's doing extremely well. Okay. We continue to increase that business, and you will see fairly strong growth in that segment of our business for this year. We see a strong business next year. We are trying to get into more value-added products as far as the oil and gas business is concerned. So that's you know, pretty good. I mean, we are happy with that part of the segment.
Sir, and one final question from my side. You know, in the U.S. markets, European markets, you are quite strong. But talking about new geographies in which probably you can export products, probably. Some emerging markets in Asia and probably Africa, South America. How do you see business shaping up there, and you know, what is the strategy in order to improve the overall distribution network there, and also increase your business share and market share in those regions?
See, we are very strong in North America. We're very strong in Europe. We export to Japan. We export to South America, to Brazil. We export a little bit to China too. So, I mean, we are in every market, but the larger opportunities for us are definitely going to be the American continent and Europe, apart from India.
Kalyani, for speaking to BloombergQuint, and a happy 2018 to you and your team.